The Presidential Anti-Crime Commission will investigate prison officials, including Bureau of Corrections Chief Nicanor Faeldon, following the questionable release of close to 2,000 convicts. Let's find out more about this probe from the PACC's Commissioner Greco Belgica. Commissioner Greco Belgica, welcome to the program. Thanks for taking our call.
Hi, ma'am. Thank you for calling us. Salamat po, good morning, good afternoon to all our listeners.
So you've launched a probe into prison's Chief Nicanor Faeldon over the questionable release of convicted inmates. What's going to be the focus of the probe, Commissioner?
Ma'am, we will look at the law and then the documents that was used, because there are also, you know, in social media and in the news that was shown that Nick Faeldon showed that his signatures was fake. So we want to see the documents and hear his side in his explanation on what transpired with the GCTA and the freeing of these 2,000 criminals or prisoners that may have included prisoners involved in heinous crime. So if laws had been violated, if corruption was had happened, if payoffs had happened, then we want to know to act on it appropriately.
Commissioner, when you start that you're going to be basing it, your probe, or you're focusing on the implementation of the law, wouldn't that be problematic to begin with? Because as it stands, there are various interpretations of the law. At the Senate hearing just today, and it's still ongoing, there are conflicting interpretations of the GCTA law. So which law or which interpretation will you use?
Our interpretation, appreciation of the case will be independent from other interpretations. We are a collegial body, and we will base our decision on existing laws, and Supreme Court decisions, and submit our recommendations to President accordingly. If they have questions on our decision, then they can question it in court. But as to the PACC, for us, we depend on our own in the evaluation of the law.
But aren't you also going to focus on possible criminal activities that may have found its way into the implementation of the GCTA law?
That's going to be part of the investigation, ma'am. Both administrative case and the issues that can be filed for criminal acts will be filed appropriately on appropriate offices like the ombudsman.
Commissioner,
but as to evidence that we will be able to get from the investigation, our recommendation for the administrative part of the case against the officials who may have violated the law, or may have there may be corruption that has been involved. We will submit accordingly.
What is
no
it?
No sacred cows.
Yes. What is it, Commissioner Belgica? What is it in the current implementation of the GCTA that makes it vulnerable to corruption? What do you think?
Well, that's what we have to look at. No, look at no, because first of all, the question of who is authorized to release these prisoners? Is it a recommending body that has to be signed by the president or by the secretary, or is it just the head of the Bureau of Prisons? That is a very important issue. Number two, what are the criteria? And clearly, with the exception of heinous crimes from being part of the GCTA law, we want to know, are there prisoners involved in heinous crimes or convicted of heinous crimes that was released? Because if that is the case, then it is a very clear violation of the law that we need people to hold accountable to.
Commissioner, based on your initial investigation, is it highly possible that money changed hands for the release of the convicts?
It is easy to suspect that, ma'am, but we need to see evidence. And we have yet to find people who will file cases against that. But yes, I've heard, Mama, reports like that. But as to evidence, and as evidence, we don't have that right now. Maybe we want to invite the public. If they would like to help, they can come here to the office and present themselves and their reports.
How extensive will the probe be, from Faeldon down to which officials, Mr. Commissioner?
We have to look at every person that those documents went through, from the investigator to the recommending authorities. We will look into it, and then up to the extent whether or not were prisoners released, who were released, why were they released? What does the law say about it? And if they have circumvented the law, we will find it. We will know it, because the documents will speak for itself.
Now, since the law was enacted in 2013, there have been about or more than 20,000 convicts who were released early, and Senator Ronald Dela Rosa once headed the BuCor as well. And according to reports and the list that I have here, he oversaw 384 releases during his time as BuCor chief. Will he be investigated as well?
Right now, we don't know, because we have not seen the document. But If the assumption is what you're saying is it was part of his time, then of course we can ask Senator Dela Rosa about to give clarification, give clarity to the issues that may come up. Hindi naman po masama yun eh. Again, as I've said, when investigations begin, it doesn't mean that the respondent is already guilty of corruption. Investigation doesn't equate to corruption. So, or guilt of corruption. So that's why it's being investigated, so that allegations, a lot of allegations are not true. But we do investigation to ascertain the truth.
And are you going to go through all of the cases released and not just the controversial ones, Commissioner?
Yeah, yes, ma'am. We have to go through it one by one and really find out if there are violations of the law that has occurred.
Commissioner Greco Belgica.
Were there favors rendered to some convicts and some prisoners? So that is clear corruption.
All right, Commissioner Greco Belgica of the Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission. We appreciate you taking our call. Thanks again for joining us this noon. Thanks so much.
Thank you, ma'am. God bless.
Thank you for watching. For more videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the I button.